Hi everyone, this is the last lab of JSON Web Token Attacks. This one is about deriving public keys from existing tokens. In this scenario, we will use this GitHub repository, in particular a Python script, which it will help us to find the current public key. It will guess mathematically the possibilities of which is the most corresponding key. Usually you will get two results, and here there you can find also the explanation mathematically, but you don't need to understand in deep what is going on. You just have to set this Docker image, and this Docker image will execute the Python script with the two key that you will give, and you will find the public key to use to exploit this server. To get this to JSON Web Token key, we need to simulate to access, because every time we access into the login page with the user Winer and Peter, we will get the JSON Web Token generated. So let's access it and save the JSON Web Token into the file. Once we save the second one, we are ready to execute the command docker.rm.it. PortSwigger / sign 2 and let's copy the two key, the first one and the second one. As you can see, usually when you are executing a Docker image, if the URL is not defined into this file, it will output an error. So you need to add here the entries to retrieve the image. I have already done this lab, so I saved it into an external file, but usually you need to know the link to go through this image. As you can see right now, we are able to retrieve all the image. The first time it will take some minutes because you need to download all the image, but if you run it more than once, you will get a result faster. This is the output log, which indicates that currently the script in Python is running. Once it will be finished, we will get these results. As you can see, it found that there is two possible key. There is the tampered JSON Web Token, which we can try to make the request in order to understand which is the correct one. If we get 200, is the correct one. If we get 302.01, the right direction. This indicates that it's not the correct one. So we can skip it and take the first one. Now, for the first one, we need to take the base64 encoded key. This key is already encoded in base64, so we need just to create the symmetric key and place into the key value the string. Now we can try to access the admin panel with this key. We need to always manage the request and change the endpoint to admin. Change also the sub in administrator and the algorithm HS256 and signing also the request with the new symmetric key previously generated. As you can see, we get the 200 code. With this 200 code, we have the confirmation that we are able to enter into the admin panel. So let's place it into the storage cookie and let's go to the admin panel and delete the user Carlos. This will solve the lab. If you enjoy the content, please leave a like and subscribe. This is the last lab in this section. I will continue my journey into the Web Security Academy. If I found something interesting, I will publish video related to it. See you soon.